listening to The Sports Coma with Big Q and the guys on the PRO Media Network.
Welcome back to The Sports Coma with Big Q and the guy. And we're talking about this free agent frenzy that the Saints basically put themselves in with. And we have a Drew Brees signing from the prior break. We broke down this agreement and let you know about that. In this particular break, we'll get more into the signings of new Saints. We already covered Kurt Coleman, the latest free agent and replacement for Kenny Vaccaro. The soon-to-be-paid Kenny Vaccaro, Kurt Coleman, comes in as an experienced guy to help those youngsters out in the secondary. And here we go again. We got two more guys brought in, one of which we're familiar with, and Patrick Robinson, of course. If you remember, Robinson was a guy that was drafted by the Saints 8 years ago out of Florida State. He did okay here. He really did okay here for the Saints for many years. The Saints ultimately end up not bringing him back. He goes on to different teams and went to the Chargers. I remember he ended up in a few other places. Yeah, he had a one-year deal with them, ended up in a few other places. But ultimately, he ended up with the Eagles, in which he really turned his career around. And he also had a great year with the Eagles, playing in that cornerback position. Helped them win the Super Bowl. So he comes back
in the Vikings game.
Come back with a Super Bowl ring on his finger. You can't beat that. And Patrick Robinson said, you know what? I want to go back home. And he's coming back home to New Orleans. So welcome back, Patrick Robinson. I'd like to give you a shout-out, brother. Welcome back to New Orleans. And, of course, the Saints net this brother on a four-year deal. It's for 4 years at $20 million. $10 million of it is guaranteed. So that's a good contract for Patrick Robinson.
And they gave him a $5 million signing bonus already. So, again, on the cap issue, he's probably only going to count against, what, a couple of million this year? On the cap?
Right. So let's look at it like this. Then there's the other guy, Demario Davis, who we signed it. But before we get into Demario, now that we covered the contract for Patrick Robinson, let's talk about impact. What does Patrick Robinson play in the scheme?
Amazing, amazing impact. If you don't already know, those new to the game Saints fans, we had Patrick Robinson for 5 years. I remember watching him. I never felt like Patrick Robinson was a bad cornerback, but he got burned. He did get beat, but we had him playing number one receivers. He was our number one cornerback. We took him, I think, like a top 10 pick. This guy was very, very talented coming out of Florida State. Some people called him the next Deion Sanders. He didn't quite pan out to be that.
That's a big lofty thing to play up to.
Exactly. Yeah. But what he can do, he can cover those quick, twitchy receivers. And he's an excellent slot corner. The only ones I think probably better than him, you would have to look at Denver and what they had going on over there. Teams like that, you had to be a pretty elite team to have a better situation than what they had at the slot. So this is a grade A to me signing. This is the cornerback that I felt we should have got. Y'all heard me and Big Q go back and forth all about Malcolm Butler. This is what DC wanted, y'all. A low-tier guy that's excellent for not a lot of money, you know what I'm saying? And I think this will improve the cornerback rotation tremendously, because he can also play outside if we need him to, if Ken Crawley look like he ain't handling this business on one of them type of days.
Well, that's a big move, because it does solidify the cornerback. I don't think this is by far the end. I could see them still approaching it at some angle to add some more talent.
Draft a low-tier cornerback.
Might get somebody else.
That would be smart.
For competition purposes.
We still got Justin Hardy and Arthur Millett, who I think can have some potential and promise. We don't know what those guys can do. They might shock us and maybe pass up P.J. Williams on a rotation. Who knows?
Well, when
training camp get here.
Well, you get two really nice pieces in the secondary, veteran guys, as opposed to what the movement was last year. The Saints in the secondary was looking at some of them youngsters. Now that they got the youngsters
the Minnesota Miracle, huh?
Yeah, oh yeah.
That's what cost us.
That's what Kurt Coleman comes in and will prevent. But here's Patrick Robinson with all those experience years or two, is a journeyman now coming back home, and what likely will probably finish up his career here in New Orleans, hopefully. And then let's move on to Demaryius Davis. Now, of course, a lot of Saints fans might not be familiar with Demario Davis. Yeah, he's a former Jet linebacker who the Saints have signed to a three-year deal worth $24 million, including the $18 million of the $24 million is guaranteed. That's a big, significant portion of his contract. Guaranteed. Now, what makes it possible for this move is that the Saints do like the fact that this guy is very durable. He doesn't miss any football. And he recorded a career-high 5 sacks last year, and the guy had 135 total tackles. 135 total tackles. That's pretty
good.
Only
the Buffalo linebacker, I think. What is his name?
Preston Brown.
Preston Brown had more at 144. This is probably, you had two or three of them top tier, and he's one of them, man. I think this is an amazing signing. Mike Nolan definitely needs to help him out in the one area that he's weak on, which is pass coverage. He's not the best pass coverage.
I wouldn't even say that about
him. He's not horrible, though.
Right. I mean, he
can be every down linebacker, in my opinion.
It is, because with the tape I was watching on Demario Davis is that he can cover. He can cover not just the run, but he can play the pass as well. And he's very smart, and he doesn't miss any tackles. Once he puts his hands on, he got you.
And y'all got to think how big this is. Also, with the addition of Anzalone coming back, who looked pretty good as a rookie.
Hold
man.
On, DC. Let me stop you before you feed him too much, because we need to get into that right quick. Let's talk about the contributions of Demario Davis. Now, for instance, the Saints signed Demario Davis. The guy's 29 years old. Okay, he's 29 years old. And that's kind of weird that they give a 29-year-old linebacker to me a three-year deal worth $24 million.
Jonathan Vilma, man. Jonathan Vilma was about 28.
And 28, we did but 28 is different from 29, though.
Oh, come on, man. You nitpicking, bro.
No.
That's like saying I got a 2018
this is a lot of money.
Then I got a 2017.
But this is a lot of money for a guy. You give him a three-year deal, he's going to be here till he's, what, 32?
Well, it's guaranteed to, $18 million is all that's guaranteed. And you're looking at, that's about what? $8 million. Well, not even $8 million a year.
No,
that's right around six, somewhere around.
So, but with age aside, though, I'm not saying that the age is slowing down, because we got the ageless one, Drew Brees, operating under quarterback. So I'm not saying
linebacker is a little different.
It's different with linebacker, exactly.
It's like a running back.
Now let's exclude that for a second, and we'll just pick that up in a later episode. But let's talk about Demaryius Davis' contribution to the Saints' defense. Obviously, he's coming in to start. Where does that put him among the linebackers we currently have?
Oh, man, there's no contest. He's the number one guy, man.
Over Klein.
Yes. A.J. Klein is overrated. He's not a bad linebacker.
I don't agree with
that. Don't get me wrong. But A.J. Klein ain't the heir apparent to nothing, man. He's not Luke Kuechly, you know what I'm saying? He's a good stand-in.
Because if he was, they wouldn't need Demario Davis.
I think he's a good Swiss Army knife. He can play any position along those three positions. And I think he's a good linebacker. But when you're talking about a guy like Demario Davis, who records 135 tackles in one season, it's no contest, man. It's not even close. This is not even a conversation. So you see what they paid him, and you see what they paid A.J. Klein. So that clearly lets you know what time it is right there. So you know what it is. I like A.J. Klein. No disrespect to you, bro. But you're not Demario Davis. This is a different breed. If we're putting it on a tier level, you got tier one, tier two, tier three. A.J. Klein's tier three. This guy's clearly tier one. And Anzalone maybe can be tier two.
I don't know. I think it's going to be when you talk about production, obviously the Saints looking at the fact that they want somebody who's going to be there. This guy is like the Drew Brees of linebackers. You know, he doesn't miss
games.
Our
linebackers always get hurt. We've had hurt linebackers for the last four or five years.
Exactly. Anzalone went down. A.J. Klein went down. Then you're working on with your second, your third and fourth linebackers last year.
We finally going to see my dream of having a 3-4 package, you think?
I don't think so. I won't go
that will far. Make you happy. You get your man A.J. Klein out there. You get to have Demario Davis out there. They're both out there. Slasher role in that package
Kaha will never see linebacker position ever again. But that's interesting. Don't think the 3-4. I think the Saints are looking at
a
4-3,
which they 3-4.
The base defense still is listed as a 4-3.
Right.
We know about
Belichick runs 3-4 all the time. He runs a base 4-3.
But remember, we had this conversation about when we talked about why they running the tree safety look so much, because the tree safety look had better personnel than the injured linebackers they was operating with the 4-3. So
that's why
that
we
was
had
something
that,
we was
that,
looking
that
at
debate
as well,
about
so.
A linebacker being a pressing knee, and you was like, well, no.
As long as they can use this, as long as they can go to the safety, why not? You know,
well,
the tree
can,
safety look,
do
why
both.
Not?
We can still do
you
both.
You can still do both. That makes you even more dangerous, because some games you might need the 4-3 versus the tree safety look. When you got a team that's can run it on you, you put that 4-3 on them versus a team that might be want to wing it on you.
You need that three safety look.
You are gonna need it, no doubt
that's,
about
that's,
it.
The league win right now is almost three cornerbacks are like starters.
Pretty much. Isn't that amazing? The game has come really far. Anyway, that's the end of that. Let's get to the next signing. We got a few minutes before we go to break. Let's talk about the newest Saint acquisition quarterback.
What?
Tom Savage. That's right, Tom Savage.
You can't be a Savage and a Saint.
You could be a Savage Saint. You could be a saintly savage.
A saintless savage.
See? But anyway, the Saints agreed to a deal. The particulars wasn't immediately released with the Saints. Hold on.
We got a one-year deal.
That's what it is. That's okay, here we go. I got it right here.
Numbers.
Yeah, I got them pulled up here. It's reported by NFLnetwork.com. It's a one-year deal worth $1.5 million with a $100,000 bonus. $100,000 bonus to... Tom Savage to be the quarterback. So 1 year, $1.5 million, $100,000 bonus to become the new backup quarterback to Drew Brees. And of course, the Saints still have Taysom Hill on the bench. So I guess it'll be a battle between the established a veteran quarterback and Taysom Hill, who Sean Payton really liked. Now, DC, how does
good.
Now quickly before we hit the break, what impact would Tom Savage have to the Saints roster?
Not much, but I think that's pretty good to get a starting quarterback basically for that price to be a backup. I mean, he was basically a starter in Houston. I think for the preseason, he probably could give us some excitement. He should be able to dominate against a lower tier competition. Drew Brees don't get hurt. It's pretty much the NFL Iron Man. So.
Well, that's Tom Savage. When we get back on the other side of the break, we'll have the discussion on whether or not this will deter the Saints from taking a quarterback in the draft, perhaps. So we'll get into that.
No.
And of course, we'll cover the other news and notes, in particular potential Saints and Jordy Nelson and a few other news, Alex Okafor, and a couple of other great Saints news.
I'm a consumer, maybe?
Perhaps. All that on the other side of the break. You're listening to the Sports Coma with Big Q and the guys.